Whether you have experience in crypto or are completely new to this mysterious world, you might have heard about forks. And no, here I'm not talking about kitchen utensils, but rather instances of changes of the blockchain's protocol. Some of you might roll your eyes and say that you don't really need to get into all these technical details. After all, we all use electricity, but not all of us can explain how it works exactly. In fact, since the moment I started with crypto and later created this channel, I met a lot of people, both online and offline, who are simply asking for tools or proven strategies designed to make them rich quickly. I get that. There is nothing wrong with that. At the end of the day, we all want simplicity. However, I have always had an issue with these get-rich-quickly schemes for a number of reasons. First, what is rich? How much is rich exactly? And second, while instant gratification sounds appealing and the notion of long and hard work doesn't, getting rich is only a halfway point. Keeping the capital that you earned is your next job. We all heard stories of people who won the lottery and had no money left less than a year. We all heard stories of people who inherited fortunes and lost it all. Sure, this might sound like extreme cases, but they do tell us that keeping and saving whatever you have is no easy task. It's one of the reasons why I always encourage you to educate yourselves and never feel like you know everything, because the truth is, you don't. Knowledge and your desire to constantly learn are some of the important tools which will help you to first earn however much you think will give you financial freedom and comfort, and second, keep it and multiply it over time. So if you did find an earning tool or a strategy that works for you, cool. But don't forget that the fundamental knowledge is just as important. Hi, I'm Vlad, and this is your Bunny Money channel with a weekly dose of finance, investing, and crypto-related info. Before we dive in into today's topic, I would like to remind you that none of the information provided here is financial advice. I'm sharing my personal experience, and it's given to you for educational purposes only. You might have heard about forks, but just to make sure that we all are on the same page here, let's define them first. To make it really simple, forks are any updates that happen on a cryptocurrency network. To be more precise, since there is no single entity that can make changes regarding blockchain, a community does it instead, altering blockchain's protocol. Blockchain is quite literally a series of blocks where a certain cryptographic function proves the authenticity of each block. There are governing rules and protocols regarding blockchain that might need to be changed over time. When the need for changes arises, all users must agree on what exactly changes and how. If the consensus doesn't happen, the chain can fork, or in other words, separate into those who are in favor of the updates and those who prefer the old ways. Now, you might wonder why there might be a need for any changes in the first place. Well, these changes on the blockchain, or you might call them updates, depending on the type of work that occurs, might happen for a variety of reasons. Some being the need for a better functionality, community disagreement, security risks. If, for example, the community sees that some of the blockchain's or coin's features can and should be improved, or it has a disagreement about how to act regarding a particular issue, a fork might appear. If, for example, there is a security risk or there was a hack, once again, the community might have different ideas about how it's best to proceed. A fork might happen. Overall, it's the clash of different visions regarding the future or a coin, and it might create its own opportunities but also pose certain risks. Depending on how the fork was created, there are two types of forks. The first type are hard forks. Hard forks describe substantial and serious changes in the code. These changes involve the very technology of the cryptocurrency. In fact, these changes are so massive that the chain actually splits. One chain continues according to the initial set of rules, while another one follows the new rules. These two chains aren't compatible because the changes affected the very core of the cryptocurrency so much that a new cryptocurrency was born. When this happens, users would need to upgrade to the new version of the network and eventually choose which way to go. Now you might wonder what would happen to your coins after such a chain split. Well, if you have tokens on the initial or old chain, you are granted them on the new one as well. The initial asset might drop in value a little bit, but this decrease is offset by the corresponding amount on the new chain. All transactions that happen before the fork will be valid on both chains. However, those that happen after fork will be valid either on one chain or another, since both chains will be two different coins. Since the changes that come with hard forks are so big and both users and miners are splitting too, hard forks are sometimes seen as risky. The second type of forks are soft forks. These can be viewed as updates or upgrades for the blockchain. In other words, users realize that some aspect of the cryptocurrency can be improved. They agree on how to do it and the changes are made. Since the chain in this case doesn't split, the changes do not cause any issues of compatibility. Those blocks that existed before a soft fork happened and after are compatible. The core rules haven't changed and there is no need for users to update. Also, no new cryptocurrency appears. I understand that everything I described so far can sound confusing, so I'm going to give you some examples of both hard and soft forks. This way it will be easier for you to understand the concept. An example of a hard fork is Bitcoin Cash. As you might have guessed already, it's a hard fork of Bitcoin, which was created in 2017. At one point, some users wanted to keep the blocks small, while others wanted for them to get bigger so that more data can be processed faster. The agreement between the two sides wasn't found, so the hard fork occurred. Those miners who supported the increase of the block size became the supporters of Bitcoin Cash. An example of a soft fork is the adoption of a segregated witness or SegWit, which altered the format of blocks. It does so by removing certain parts of a transaction, filling up space on the chain. These updates still allowed new and old blocks to interact with each other and no new cryptocurrency was created as a result. So this pretty much sums up everything you need to know about crypto forks, so that the next time you are reading news, you can understand what exactly is happening to a particular coin and what you can do in this case. This was our episode for today. If you found it useful, consider subscribing and clicking the notification button. For more crypto-related knowledge, check out our other videos. If you have questions, leave a comment. I'm Vlad, and this is your Bunny Money channel. See you in the next episode.